Welcome back. Today we are back on the E92. So what we need to do today, we need to go ahead and trim out all the parts that we replaced. The door here, you guys can see we've got it all sanded down. We put a little tape over the sticky stuff right here, that way we can reuse it and not have to replace it or anything. We've got the fender all sanded, ready to trim out, and of course we've got our quarter panel here. We just need to sand the primer here on the inside with a 400 and water. That way it's nice and smooth and the paint adheres very well to the primer. Once we get it all sanded down, we'll trim it out, we'll let it dry, and then we'll probably go ahead and install the airbags inside. What do you think, Nate?
Yeah, and the rest
while
of the
this is drying, we'll let it set up just enough to where you can kind of touch it, and then we'll start working on the airbags, which do actually have to be drilled out and pop back in with rivets. So that's gonna be a big task. But for now, let's just get this thing painted and then we'll move on to the interior. Unfortunately, they are riveted on, so we have to use this drill to take all these rivets out right here. Basically, all you have to do really is just drill out the center of it, and the cap will pop off and it will release the airbag. All right, so I got the airbag out and came across a very horrible discovery. It has some very special looking rivets right here. They have a long shank that extends through this mounting bracket. As you can see, that's where I drilled off the cap, and the rivet extends past this and into the body of the car. So I've actually never seen a rivet like this. I don't know how they work even. So we're going to run down to CarQuest and see if they have anything similar. If they don't, what I'm thinking is, and it was actually Nate's idea, we could just drill those holes out a little bit more and just pop some, rib nuts in there. And then we can just put bolts in there. Everywhere else, we'll put the rivets. So we're gonna run down to CarQuest, and worst case scenario, we'll get some rib nuts from them.
Those are some long ones right there.
Hey, I need these. But I also need 14 rivets that are this diameter. They don't have to be this long though. Like, you guys have them in the back? Or is that all you have up front? That's all you have?
I got a few.
Hi, Julie.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you doing?
I'm doing good.
That's good.
So you just need more of these?
No, these are the special ones I need. I don't need them this long. They can be like halfway.
Mm-hmm.
That I was just getting for the diameter, you know. Yeah,
yes,
that should work.
Oh, those are gold. Those are pretty expensive.
I paint the mix.
Yeah, they're
You see their gold, Julian.
They are.
And you throw that gold piece away, so it must be really expensive.
No, we're taking that to the jewelry. We're going to take that to the jewelry. What's the name?
For it.
Yeah.
All right, check it out. We got that airbag in, and it looks really good. I love the way that these rivets work. When I was popping them in, like, you could see it just squeezing in super tight. So very happy with how solid everything is. It's really nice and on there. Now what I need to do is I need to get rid of the rest of these. I drilled them out, but if you look right here, we still have a part of it left. So basically what I usually do is take a sharp chisel and a hammer, and since they are aluminum, we'll just shear them off. So we are back here at the shop. It's Saturday, and we need to get this car off the rack. Check this out, guys. Got all the interior put together. I have not installed the visors because I did misplace the bolts from them yesterday, and then I found them today. So I need to do that real quick. We'll do that here in a little bit, but we've got everything assembled. We've got the ceiling in. We've got the airbags on. We've got the airbag light turned off. Everything is hooked up, everything works. There's no engine light, there's no airbag light, there's no traction light, there's no kind of lights on the dash, and even the TPMS light went out, so I'm very happy about that. The AC works. Basically the car is ready for paint. Once we get this thing painted, all we have to do is assemble it and it will be done. So what we're gonna do right now real quick, we're gonna crank it up and get it off the frame machine and into the bay where the F80 is. Man, I love this thing. Honestly, I probably need to get rid of it because the sound power ratio and look ratio on this car is way too high. Like, it sounds good, it has good power, and it looks really good. So it's like the perfect combination for trouble. You know, either death, tickets, jail, something stupid for sure, you know? I feel like you have to have a lot of self-control and discipline to own a vehicle like this. Something I don't have. We are back at the shop and I'm super happy with the way the car drives. Everything is absolutely exactly how I want it to be at this moment in time. Everything except for that wheel. But we'll take care of that. We'll get that fixed in some of the future videos. But that's gonna be it for this video, guys, and for this car for a while. We need to jump onto Jake's Mustang, which is right there. Look at him over there with B-Tune. We need to get that quarter panel done. We need to get the other Mustang done. So this thing right here, we're probably going to have to maybe put Paul on it. You know, maybe let Paul do it while we do the framework or something like that. Or we can just prep it real quick, get it painted real quick, get it all done, put back together, and put it in a big bubble. You know, that way nobody can touch it, nobody can see it. No, I'm just kidding. This thing right here is going up for sale the second the last clip. The second the last clip goes in on this thing is going up for sale for sure. I don't need this thing. As much as I love it, I think I need to get rid of it. It was fun. And get the F80 fixed. Because that's really the dream car. I just couldn't pass this one up because it was so clean. And I really wanted to fix it. And we had a really good time fixing it. And we're still going to have a lot of more good times with it. But like I said, definitely going to get rid of it. And yeah, so stay tuned for the future videos on this, and also stay tuned for another Mustang video, which is coming soon. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace out.